I've been working on automatic stall and crash avoidance. It's a quick demonstration. I'm moving the table at 40 inches a minute and turning the spindle at 100 revolutions per minute. As I touch the spindle, you see the table slow down, and as I release it, the load is released and the table continues at 40 inches a minute. Now this is potentially really useful for new machinists who are uncertain of the feed rates that they should use, or others who want to keep their machines working near full capacity, or for machine materials of heterogeneous hardness, where you never really know when you might encounter a hard spot, maybe in cast iron. This idea isn't new. The earliest reference I found to it is a 1968 Bendix US Air Force contract report. But the only similar implementations that I found on YouTube are on Sam Kolick's channel, and the links to those videos are in the description. Well, the Haas controller has auto feed. Adaptive control deserves more attention and development for do-it-yourself and small CNC machines, where intelligent controllers would help to make CNC machining accessible by more people. All tests are performed while cutting aluminum with the spindle turning at 3000 RPM, which is the highest speed at which the 750 watt DMM servo and DYN4 drive would deliver maximum torque. A Lakeshore carbide 1/2 inch diameter 3-flute stub end mill with a 40 inch per minute feed rate is used. The program relies on comparing the current operation to features of successes and failures. A 3/8 inch deep full width cut requires nearly 4 times the available horsepower, so there will be a quick crash. The spindle is warning that excessive power is demanded about 175 milliseconds before the x-axis faults. Without intervention, the x-axis faults before the spindle drive faults 200 milliseconds later. Reviewing 5 millisecond resolution data from the servo drive, we find a clear signal of an impending stall. Recognition of that signal is added to the LinuxCNC module, and the NC program is paused when a forthcoming stall is predicted. Now that crashes can be predicted and the NC program paused, let's adjust the feed rate and avoid stopping the program. A 1/2 inch full width, 1/8 inch deep cut is estimated to require 25% more power than available. This gives a recording of a successful operation that's at the limits of the machine. Now parameters for the control loop between the spindle torque sensor and the adaptive feed rate can be estimated. The first attempt takes a pretty heavy cut with a control loop set to stay below 70% of the spindle's peak capacity, well below what's required for this cut at 40 inches per minute. The stall watch protection is disabled and the adaptive feed is enabled. And it's easy to see the feed start and stop and the adaptive feed rate multiplier shown as the yellow graph line bouncing between 0 and 1. The second attempt takes a more conservative cut, but the load is inconsistent with the last section requiring much greater power. The feed rate is slowed, so the spindle has time to remove the material and decrease the load below the target, avoiding the stall while continuing to make progress. The final demo is probably the most common, an operation that's near or just beyond the machine's capacity. Targeting 100% peak capacity of the spindle, cutting 1/2 inch wide slot, 1/8 inch deep, there are a few stops and starts that might have otherwise been stalls. There are marks left on the slot walls where feed stopped, but they would easily be removed in a finishing pass. I hope this video does enough to show the potential usefulness of adaptive control. I have 4 possible improvements that I'd like to make to this program if there is interest. The first is currently when a stall is predicted and the forward motion is stopped, the spindle keeps moving, and this can really gum up tools. So in a situation that you're going to walk away from the machine and you're using the stall watch to protect the machine from crashing, you'd like also the spindle to stop too. So I'd like to add that into the code and give a nice simple way to restore forward motion and spindle when the operator returns. The second is to smooth out the adaptive feed rate. There's a lag between when an adjustment to the feed rate is made and when a change in torque is measured. And that lag allows the control loop to become overly excited about the last measurement. So the control loop quickly goes from everything's great maximum feed rate to everything's awful zero feed rate and back to maximum feed rate. The third thing I'd like to do is if a tool is underutilized to increase the feed rate. And this can be approximated today by setting the feed override to say 200% and then allowing this software to adjust the adaptive feed rate as needed. And you just keep reducing the threshold until the number of times that the adaptive feed rate is kicking in is reasonable. And finally, supporting number three would be to add another column to the tool library that's the preferred load on the tool.